Hi friends, this is Fani Bhushan Nagula. As part of Software Testing Foundations, today we are going to learn 7 principles of software testing. The testing principles are very important for software engineer, and they may be developer or business analyst or a software tester, but these are very, very important for everyone in the software life cycle who is playing different roles in the team. So because they provide the guidance for defining testing activities like reviews, test case design, test case execution, etc. Let's understand what are these principles. So we have 7 principles. The first principle says that testing shows the presence of defects. So the test, this principle tells that this is an execution-based activity to detect defects, and the testing can show the defects are present, but cannot prove that there are no defects. That's the meaning of this principle. It shows the defects are present, but cannot prove that there are no defects. The tester executes test cases and compares the actual results to those specified in the requirement or specification document. If the actual is deviating from the expectations, then the quality issues should be addressed. So this principle is because it is an execution activity, it is clearly separating the debugging activity from testing. So you might have seen the developer always talks about the code debugging. So the code debugging is not equivalent to the testing activity, because the testing is the software testing having certain objective. What is our objective? The testing is to reveal defects and fix those defects. And testing is always reduces the number of undiscovered defects remaining in the software. But even if no defects are found, it is not a proof of correctness. So we are saying, even though if there are no defects are found after thorough testing, then it is not a proof of correctness. Even after the testing the application product thoroughly, we cannot say that it's 100% bug free. That's very, very important to, very important. And we cannot say the product is a bug free product or a zero defect product, because we have done the test execution as per the plan, and we have covered the functionality to find the defects. So we are executing the test cases and finding the defect, but we are not guaranteeing that there are no defects. And the second principle talks about exhaustive testing is impossible. So while you're executing the test cases, so we should not assume that the software under test always be provided with valid inputs. So for example, so we have tested it through the using valid inputs, but the customer or the user has given invalid input by mistake, and the system not responding to those, not able to handle those invalid inputs, and the customer will be frustrated with that, and the customer may not return to the application. So we need to, the application should guide the user if they have given any invalid input and explain that what next steps needs to be taken. So, but at the same time, what we need to understand is testing everything, including all combinations of inputs. So all valid or invalid combinations and the preconditions. So sometimes may not be, means mostly exhaustive testing is impossible. So testing all combinations in the sense, all valid and invalid combinations is not possible. Let's understand how it will be. For example, let me go to a calculator. For example, we have five fields in a page, and each field can take five valid inputs, five possible valid inputs. Let's understand five valid inputs. I have five fields. One, so five times each field can take five valid inputs. So how many combinations we may get here? See, 3125 combinations. So you need to, if you want to execute the test case with each combination, you should have the test case, the number of test case, 3125 test cases to be executed to validate one page or one scenario. So this is very, very difficult. Why? Because the projects are always with time bound. So we may not have the time to execute all these combinations. So what we need to do? So we need to manage this risk. So it is, the managing risk is one of the most important activity and reason for testing in any project. So we need to understand these time scales, and then based on that, we need to manage the risk. So that is the reason the principle says exhaustive testing is impossible. And the third principle says early testing. Early testing in the software development life cycle. So in the software development life cycle, testing activities should be started as early as in the software development life cycle. So from the requirement analysis phase and continue throughout the software development life cycle in parallel with the development activities. It should be in parallel to requirement, design, development, testing. So it should be started as early as possible in the software development life cycle. So the fourth one says defect clustering. That a small number of, what is meant by defect clustering? A small number of modules contains most of the defects discovered during the pre-release testing. That means part of your testing internally before you have released to the product, before you have released the application or the product to the customer, most of the defects are occurred in the, or identified in some of the modules in the application. For example, if you have in an application, if you have two modules, A, module A and module B, testers have identified, for example, in module A, they have identified 20 bugs, and the module B, they have identified 5 defects. So the probability of the existence of additional defects in module A is higher than module B. Why? Because it may be due to severe causes. For example, complexity or poor design might be the reason for this defect clustering. So the defect clustering says that a small number of modules contain most of the defects. So that is clustering. And the fifth one talks about pesticide paradox. Pesticide paradox. What is meant by this? If the same kind of test are repeatedly executed again and again, so the same set of test cases will no longer be able to find any new bug. So for example, so we are developing an application, and we're continuously doing regression testing. So we are receiving the build and we are doing regression testing. And then again, we have received build, we have started again regression testing, and we are reusing the same test case again and again, executing the same test case. But the same test cases is not able to find the defect. It is not able to find the defect. So then what we should do, this is called to overcome this issue, pesticide paradox. It's really very, very important to review our test cases regularly and refine our test cases. This is pesticide paradox. So we need to review our test case. So whenever your test cases is no longer valid for identifying an effect, identifying issues or defects, so we need to refine our test cases very frequently. We need to understand that why this test cases is no longer applicable to, is why it is not identifying the issue. So we need to refine our test cases, rewrite our test cases, and understand how we can break the system, how we can potentially find more defects. So we need to innovatively refine our test cases. This is called pesticide paradox. And the sixth one, testing is context dependent. So the testing is basically context dependent. So different kinds of sites are tested differently. The same testing method may not be applicable to every application. So it is context dependent. For example, safety and critical software is tested differently from the e-commerce. For example, so healthcare applications. So we need to apply different testing methods. So the e-commerce application and healthcare applications are not, means in terms of the test strategy, it is not same. So we need to apply a different methodology based on the context. So the testing effort should be based on the what is to be tested, and the testing focus will depend on what is more important for the type of application. So this is very important. And the seventh one, absence of errors fallacy. So absence of errors means if the system built is unusable and does not fulfill the user's needs and expectations, then finding and fixing defects does not help. So if whatever we have built as part of the application development, all the features, whatever we have developed, if those are not usable, and if those features are not helping the customer needs and expectations, then this testing activities, whatever we are doing, does not help anyone. So finding and fixing the defects does not help. So this is called absence of errors fallacy. So these are the seven testing principles. So thanks for watching the session. In the next session, we will learn more about the software testing foundations. Thank you.